Is your company required to collect and pay sales tax to two different agencies for the same sale? Well, then you need to know how to record combined sales tax rates. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Some sales require that you pay sales tax to two different agencies for the same sale. If you are required to do this in your situation, then you must add a combined rate to the list of rates in the sales tax settings. For example, let's imagine we now have special sales that require that we collect and pay sales tax on these special sales for both Tennessee and Wyoming. The Tennessee sales tax rate is 7%, and the Wyoming sales tax rate is 4%. We must add a combined rate called T&W, which stands for Tennessee and Wyoming. This tax rate will be for any sale of products that require this combined rate. So let's go ahead and add our first combined rate. We click Taxes. Then once we are in the Sales Tax Center, we click Sales Tax Settings. First, we have to add the agencies. Add agency, and then we pull down, and you might have to scroll down on this little gray nub that they give here for Tennessee. ST is somewhere. No, this is county. We want to go down to where the states are. Tennessee. Okay, filing frequency, put monthly just in case. And the start date, we can put October 1 of 2020 and save. Now we also have to add Wyoming. Click the pull down, scroll all the way down to the W's, Wyoming. Filing frequency, monthly, and again, we start on October 1. What we learned in the prior video is you would have to get the filing frequency from your accountant or the state agency's website or by calling them. Click Save. Now we have the two agencies on the list. And now that we have both agencies on our list, we now add the combined rate. Click Add Rate and choose Combined Rate. Now, the name of the combined rate will be T ampersand W. Okay, now the nickname of the first one will be TEN for Tennessee. And notice Tennessee is already in the top section, so you don't have to go fishing for your tax agency because it's already on the list of saved agencies on the top. Click Tennessee Department of Revenue, and Tennessee's rate was 7%. The next rate was Wyoming. WY is enough for the nickname. And again, that's also an agency that should be on the top of the scroll list because it's already saved. And we click Wyoming, and we put in the 4%. So the combined total will be 11% when we make a sales receipt or an invoice. We click Save, and now you can see the nicknames and the total of the combined rate in the section of rates in the Sales Tax Center, or in the Settings section of the Sales Tax Center. Now we'll go back to the Sales Tax Center, and we will do, notice there is zero due now because we have not used that rate on any transaction. However, let's imagine on December 1 of 2020, we sold 2 apples and 6 bananas to a new customer named Martha Manystate, and we received cash today, which means we will be making a sale receipt. And we will use the new combined rate. So let's go ahead and do that. Click New, Sale Receipt. The customer, we have to click Add New and put the name. Spelling doesn't count. Click Save. Scroll down. Now, we said how many bananas? We said 2 apples and 6 bananas. So, apples, 2. Okay, tax, bananas, 6. Now, we haven't chosen a sales tax. Oh, click taxable, don't forget. Scroll down. We have not chosen a rate. We're going to choose T&W, see the math, just so that it explains, close it out. I like to click see the math to make sure it calculates it correctly. So this looks like about 11% of the subtotal. Now when we click save and close, you can see if we scroll down, we now have this much upcoming for Maine and this much upcoming for Tennessee, because 220 out of the 6th, whatever what it was, for sales tax is payable to Maine, and 434 is payable to Tennessee. You can also see this distinction if you click Reports, Trial Balance, and you can see each of the separate individual tax agencies have been put in the trial balance for the specific amount owed for that tax agency. And when it's time to pay, you'll click Taxes, and you'll click View Return and pay it exactly the way we learned in a prior video.